Father God, bless every person here tonight, God. Bless them as you can only bless them, God. Anoint as you can only anoint, God. Set free as you can only set free, God. Give grace and mercy here tonight, God, that everything will be all right. Oh, Lord, we love you. In and out, God, we love you. Because we know that you're an all-time God. And you make everything A-okay. Oh, God, thank you now for what you're getting ready to do in this place. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. And amen. Somebody ought to shout hallelujah. Somebody else ought to shout hallelujah. And tell the Lord, say, Lord, it is well with my soul. Yes, yes, yes. There is a word in the house tonight that's going to bless us right where we are.
Yeah.
I didn't come to bother you tonight, but I did come to force you to think about it. I know this is your Valentine night. You still got time, amen?
Amen.
To get your candy and cookies. You still got time to dive into your Valentine's. Let's go to 2 Chronicles. Hallelujah. 5th chapter. Somebody else, thank you, Lord. God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is. Mm-hmm. I've been an awesome God. Anybody in the house know that?
Yes,
Lord. So, let's stand. Someone please read that 11th through 14th verses of that said text and see what the Lord has in store for the Living Word House tonight.
The priests then withdrew from the holy place. All the priests who were there had consecrated themselves regardless of their divisions. All the Levites who were musicians, Asaph, Hermon, Judah, and sons and relatives, stood on the east side of the altar, dressed in fine linen and playing cymbals, harps, and lyres. They were accompanied by 120 priests sounding trumpets. The trumpeters and singers joined in unison, as with one voice, to give praise and thanks to the Lord. Accompanied by trumpets, cymbals, and other instruments, they raised their voices in praise to the Lord and sang, Amen. He is good, his love endures forever. Then the temple of the Lord was filled with a cloud, and the priests could not perform their service because of the cloud. For the glory of the Lord filled the temple of God.
So that priests could not stand to minister by reason of the cloud. For the glory of the Lord had filled the house of God.
Amen.
Now, certainly tonight, with the presence of the Holy Spirit, I want to talk about this message entitled, I'm not next in line, but I'm now.
Amen.
Can't hear nobody.
Amen.
I'm not next in line, but I'm now.
Amen.
Listen, when God comes, before you take your seat, when God comes and he'll allow you to see the cloud of his presence, don't you know that's right now? That's not next in line. That's right now miracle. That's right now mercy. That's right now for this. I come here on this special night to tell you to adopt it. I'm not next in line. I'm right now. Matter of fact, I can't see no line. All I see, brothers and sisters, is by right now.
Yes,
tell somebody next to you, right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Right
now.
Right now.
Right now.
See, let me tell you, I've learned this week alone, Queen, if you stand still, he'll work it out.
Yes, he will.
No longer am I going to fight with the devil.
Come on.
I'm telling you what I know. Lord, I wish I could testify, but I can't do it. It's too fresh to testify. But if you learn to stand still, God will be your right now.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Can't hear nobody.
Yes, amen.
You learn to stand still, God will be your right now. Look, it bothers me and puzzles me so much that we really can't get what we want from God because we are in our own way. We are our own enemy. We talk about who's our enemy, but we're our first enemy. Talk about what we want and how we want it. You got to learn to worship God. Look to see, worship God on your needs and your wants. You got to learn to worship God right now if you really want a right now blessing. Somebody please say right now.
Right now.
This text tonight and dealing with Solomon, and the Bible says all the work that Solomon had made for the house of the Lord was finished, and Solomon brought all the things that David his father had dedicated, even the silver and the gold and all the other instruments, and put it among the treasure of the house of God. In other words, what you want from the Lord, you got to trust the house of God with it. You got to trust the house of God with your deliverance.
Yes, sir.
You got to trust it.
Yes, sir. Yes.
You can't trust God and you still fearful of where you're going. You want healing? You got to trust God to heal you that cancer. You got to trust God to heal you that brokenness. You got to trust God to heal you of your habits. You got to bring it to the house at Solomon's house and David and leave it in the house of God.
Amen.
Trust God with it. You may say, well, Pastor, I tried to trust God with it, but those that I'm dealing with it won't allow me to forget it. Well, you got to disconnect your circle.
Right. Amen.
If you got it and they don't have it, then it's time to find you some new filibusters. Anybody here tonight?
Come on, Bishop.
If you really, really got it.
Yes.
And you know you got it. You don't have time to question what God has done.
Amen.
Because when you really put your heart into the presence of God, he'll bless you when you think not.
Amen.
He'll bring you what you need.
Yes, he will.
If ain't nothing but a spoonful of food, he'll bring it to you.
Yes.
Come on.
I can't hear nobody tonight.
Amen.
But you got to trust God. You said, oh, I want to be where you are, sister. I want to be where you are, brother. But let me tell you something. You ain't been through the hell I've been through to get to where I am.
Come on.
Come on.
Ain't no Santa Claus going to bring you this. Somebody please say glory, hallelujah.
Glory, hallelujah.
Yeah, the Bible said the difference was the Lord's glory filled the temple.
Mm-hmm.
When you let the Lord's glory fill where you are,
man,
all you got to do is keep your mind still.
Oh, yeah.
You let God's glory fill us. And even when it looks bleak, God will show up and he'll show out. And God will give you exactly what you need. Uh-huh. The Bible said in this text tonight that then Solomon assembled the elders of Israel and all the heads of the tribe and the chief of the father and the children of Israel unto to Jerusalem to bring up the ark of the covenant of the Lord out of the city of David, which is in Zion. Uh-huh. In other words, what you want, you got to plan it.
Amen.
What you're looking for, you got to give it.
Amen.
and it begins with your worshiping with the presence of the Lord.
Yes.
When it comes to time for church to meet, and these folk and these people rounds up, and they hurl up, and see, you got to learn to get your heart right before you come to the house, you don't come to the house to bathe. You don't come to the house to take a bath. You come to the house to glorify God, the God that you brought in here with you. I can't hear nobody, And see, when you understand and you know that I'm not next in line, but I am right now, And when you know that you know that you know, Brothers, that you're right now, you got the benefit from the God's glory. You got the benefit from God's mercy. You got the benefit from his finesse, And know that everything is all right, Let me tell you something. Your presence is all you need, Your presence will change a whole generation, If you will learn to trust God with it, Your presence in God, All you got to do sometimes is think about it, See, if your good don't find you and bless you, if something ain't good about you.
Amen. Come on now.
Okay. Come on.
I said if your good don't bless you every now and then, that something ain't good about you.
Amen.
Every now and then somebody ought to say, God is good.
Amen.
But if something don't happen to you every now and then, you're not able to say God is good. If you don't feel something every now and then, you won't know how good God is, But when you feel something every now and then, when your hand goes up and wave at the Lord every now and then, I feel the Spirit, I feel the presence of God, I feel the glory of God. In other words, every now and then, you want to get caught up in the presence of God. You want to get caught up in the atmosphere of him.
Yes, Lord.
Every now and then, you ought to be able to tell the Lord the truth, that I'm not the same. I feel like going on. I feel like moving on. I can't stay in my seats no longer. I can't stay where I used to be, because I feel the presence of God. See, when you feel the presence of God, it's only an incline that God is getting ready to do something in your behalf. God is getting ready to move for you. Do I have any moves, shakers in here tonight? I know it's Valentine, and you said I'm all day long. I'm waiting for something, but all you got to do is tell the Lord thank you, that you know what love is all about, because you love the Lord, right where he is in your life. Do I have any Lord lovers in here tonight? I'm not next in line, but I am now. God told you that he's going to do it. You're going to put a pin in it.
Yes.
And wait on the Lord. Now, the best gift you can get on this Valentine night is to worship with a praise unto the Lord. Because if you learn how to worship with a praise unto the Lord, see, when worship began, it's included in your atmosphere. It included with a praise. Not only with a praise, but you ought to have a prayer in your heart by calling on the name of the Lord. Bless his name. Now notice him by praising God. By the way, you ought to have a praise on your heart. You ought to have a praise in your belly. Do I have anybody? I have a Lord on anything good for you today. I have the Lord said anything to you. your spirit that will take you to your next level. Do I have anybody in here tonight that love the Lord enough to know that this too shall pass? I tell you what you ought to do, even when your neighbors are mistreating you, you ought to praise the Lord to have a neighbor. You ought to praise the Lord to have a neighbor like that, who can make you think about it, who can make you tell the Lord thank you. Because it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would I be? They praise God as a person. They begin by praising God for who he is. That is the reason for praise that will never cease. See, I don't know about you tonight, but when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, all I can do is praise his holy name. Do I have any praises in here tonight? Has God ever done anything awesome for you? I can raise up both hands and even both feet, because it has not been for the Lord on my side. The enemy would have decreased a long time ago. I don't know about you, but I'm not next in line, but I'm right now. So you're thinking, you know, that you're right now blessing. You ought to bless the Lord right now, because God is an awesome God. God is an almighty God. All I know is I'm not next in line, but I'm right now for my miracle. I'm right now for my blessing. I'm right now for my increase. I ain't waiting on no income. I ain't waiting on no income taxes. I've already got it right now. Right now. Don't give me no deadline. Right now. Don't give me no tomorrow. Right now.
Yes, Lord.
Right now. God will give you the desires of your heart.
Yes. Yes, he will.
If you let him have it.
Yes.
Lord, I'm short. What must I do? Lord, I'm hungry. What must I do? Lord, I need you. What must I do?
Yes.
Praise him.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Even when you don't understand what's going on, praise the Lord.
Yes.
Secondly, if you not next in line, and you're right now, you got to praise God for power.
Mm-hmm.
See, God is the mediator. God can shift, or he can pull you in.
Mm-hmm.
See, you still holding on to what they didn't do right.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of thanking God that you brought it back to me.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody here tonight?
Amen.
You're wasting your time, and you ought to be not questioning God, but praising God. God has the ability to put you and to force you into supernatural power to accomplish his will.
Mm.
May I say tonight that God has not changed. He is still the same today as he ever have been. He's still in all power in heaven and even in earth.
Yes.
He's still the great I am. Somebody please say, the great I am.
The great I am.
And he's still a God who's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think.
Oh, yeah.
And God's word says, whatever you ask in his name, he will deliver. Because God, his time is not the same.
Yes.
And we must understand that God has a plan to move you from A to Z in his own time.
Yes.
How many mountains has he already moved for you?
Come on now.
Yes, Lord.
How many times does he come when you think he wasn't going to come?
Amen.
How many times did God bring you out of a situation that you cost yourself?
Come on now.
Amen.
Did you praise him for that?
Yes.
How many times have you seen God to do the impossible? Impossible simply mean, Brother Walter, you saw no way out or in. Everything was just blocked, but you made it out.
Yes.
See, I don't know about you tonight, but how many times has he moved to answer your prayer?
Yes.
Did you ever think that God only wants a praise from you? God didn't ask you for half of your blessings. He said, just give me the credit of doing it for you.
Amen.
Because I am that I am. Somebody say, I am that I am.
I am.
I am that I am. The God that I am.
Yes, yes, yes.
Understand now, God doesn't need any cheerleaders. But he needs some praises. God doesn't need any mind readers at night, but he do need some praises.
Yes.
Praise God for that he's done for you.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Praise God for that he's getting ready to do for you.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I'm not next in line. I'm right now. Mm-hmm. And Lord knows I serve a right now God.
Yes.
Somebody ought to say, thank you, Lord. They worship with their prayers.
Mm-hmm.
You can't be shifty. On the day, bad news came through tonight, you're off tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
God can do it midnight or noon. He can do the same lesson.
Yes.
Listen, you can't decrease your praise because of what you're going through with. You can't stop praising God because things don't happen the way you think they ought to happen. You can't stop praising God because of your mishaps. Perhaps it was you, but God will still keep you from the disaster.
Amen.
Come on now.
You can't stop God because a friend decided they didn't want to be your friend anymore. You can't stop serving God because you lost your job. God allow you to drop something. He got something else for you to pick up.
Come on. Yes, he does.
That's why you got to keep preaching it.
Yes.
Come on. Tell it.
You can't stop marrying because of a bad marriage.
Amen.
You can't stop having friendship because of a bad friend.
Amen.
Come on now.
You can't stop going to church because you feel like somebody in church don't like you. You can't stop doing what God wants you to do because it's not your way. All you know is that I'm next right now. I'm now. My blessing's coming right now. I don't care how hellish you are. I'm serving God. I don't care how disobedient you are. I'm serving God. I don't care how you look. I'm a child of God, and I come to get what God has for me. Get out of my way, because I'm looking for my right now miracle, right now blessing. You're not going to don't rob me from my blessing. I don't care how short my hair may be, how long it may be. I don't care if it ain't even mine. I'm still looking for my right now blessing. No words. I've come to a point in my life. Church folks don't matter because I'm looking to God for my miracle and my blessing. I'm sick and tired of being where I am. And you got to say that. I'm sick and tired of trying to determine whether you love me, like me, or hate me. It doesn't matter. You are being moved by God. You got to put this on the table and not deal with it, but live with it. Well, I like going on there, but they look at you so strange. Let them look. The reason they look at they want to be like you.
Come on, yes.
Come on.
Yes, Lord.
Let me say that one again.
They don't have enough sense to tell you how beautiful you are.
Amen.
Smile at them and keep them docious.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Lord.
In other words, they don't have what you have.
Yes.
They think they have it. Why are they so close? It ain't your business.
Amen.
You develop your relationship.
Come on, come on, tell it.
Don't worry about what somebody else have. Yeah. Just because they're your friend doesn't mean any crazy stuff going on.
Mm-hmm.
Cut that mess out.
Come on.
Cut that stuff out. You go develop something. I see them riding together all night. Must be something going on in there. Jesus. Christ. I ain't never seen two that close. Well, you get close. Then you have to answer. Anybody here tonight?
Come on,
Bishop. Glory to God.
Develop and maintain what God has for you.
Yes.
My motto in life is just squeeze and just live and let go. See, I don't mind telling you in a minute, in a hurry, it's not what you do, it's how you do it. You don't do some things in life, you never learn what life is all about.
Yes.
You walk around looking like a holy chicken.
Come on now.
Afraid of everything.
Yes, sir.
But every now and then, you want to experience something.
Something.
And tell the Lord, thank you.
Yes, God.
And now I can make a decision. Now, that's where I want to be in life because God gave you the opportunity to just live and enjoy life. God doesn't care about you running around trying to be a perfect Christian because you cannot be a perfect Christian because whatever is in you is coming out sometime or another. Huh? But God gives you the power to control. God gives you the power to get delivered. God gives you the power to be delivered. God gives you the authority to make decisions. Uh-huh. That He can use you going and coming. Uh-huh. Do I have anybody here tonight that want to understand how good God is? Uh-huh. I don't know about you, but prayer will fulfill you. Prayer. Will bring you out. Prayer will keep you covered day and night. Do I have any witnesses? You better understand that God will use you one more time. You better learn how to worship God with your power. Worship God in the power. Worship God. You ought to need to stop worrying about this and worrying about that. But tell the Lord, Lord, I want you to handle this. You told me that weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Why are you handling that, Lord? I'm getting my joy. I'm getting my groove. I'm pledging you. I'm pleasing you. I'm praising you, God. I'm worshiping you, God. I don't know what's going to happen, but all I know is, Lord, 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 everything is gonna be all right. Do I have anybody here tonight that's sanctified? Holy Ghost, don't see my head. Don't care how the devil come. Don't care where the devil come from. I'm gonna stand and do what the Lord has already commissioned me to do. Somebody else says, thank you, Lord. Thank you, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. See, some of y'all tonight need to knock them chips off your shoulders and praise God. Tell God, say, God, I'm not next in line, but I'm right now. I'm right now. I'm not next in line. I've been standing long enough. I come to get what I need tonight. I'm gonna get what I need tonight. I'm gonna get my miracle tonight. I ain't going through this hell no more. I'm gonna be free tonight. I'm gonna be sanctified tonight. I'm gonna be covered tonight. Want my family covered tonight. I ain't want my dog covered.
Yes,
sir. Tell somebody, look at here. I'm not next in line, but I'm right now.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
I believe tonight, if you really talk to the Lord, everybody here be right now. Everybody here get blessed tonight. Everybody here get consecrated tonight. Everybody here get delivered tonight. Everybody here get free tonight. Everybody get free of debt tonight. Everybody get a job you want tonight. Everybody make the money you want to make tonight. Prosperity will come in your house tonight. But you got to trust God. You got to trust who you are, God. And tell God, God, I need you. Like never before, God. I really, really need you, God. God, I got to have you, God. I'm sick and tired of what I'm going through with. God, I need you, God. I got to have it, God. I got to have every drop of you, God. I want to feel. I want to feel like going home. I want to feel like dancing. I want my shout back. I want my dance back. I want a miracle, God. God, I want to be free of you. God, I'm sorry where I've been, God. Sorry how I acted, God.
Thank
you got to trip down. Tell the Lord, I don't want no more of this. God, I need you. Come back to me. Give me what I need. I want to feel you again. Lord, 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 Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, God. In other words, you got to proclaim what you want from the Lord. See, when the Lord began to move in the people's heart, They did not remain silent, but they began to proclaim his word. It is worth noting tonight that you got to practice until you get it right.
Yes.
Every now and then you're going to bump your head while you're practicing. But it's okay to look up and get up and tell the Lord,
yes,
thank you, Holy Ghost.
Thank you.
I've come too far to let go now.
Yes.
God will do it. God's word would show a bear. And you know you can believe it and praise God. Not only are we to just praise God, but we got to rejoice in the presence of God. You can't rejoice in God when you got malice in your heart.
Amen.
You can't rejoice in God when you don't love nobody. You can't rejoice in God when you feel like you're the only one got it going on. You can't rejoice in God when he can't trust you.
Yes.
Because every now and then you're going to have a hiccup. God will give you some instructions with that hiccup. Not only will he give you instructions, but he'll bless you with those hiccups. Somebody ought to say, thank you, Lord. That's a blessing I'm looking for. You ought to be able to take a stand tonight and say, Lord, you can use me. Try me one more time to do what you want me to do. Try me one more time to do what you want me to do. Fourthly, tonight, if God is going to use you, you got to learn how to work the crowd. You got to learn how to work what God has put around you. If everything around you makes you sick, you in trouble.
Amen.
You got a flu and don't even know it. It used to be the flu bug, but it's the flu now. Somebody ought to say, glory to me. Glory to God. In other words, you ought to come in here with your holy self. Find something that will love you back. I don't mean coming here looking down and looking at people like you've lost your mind. You ought to be glad to see Reverend Joy. And I look at him and say, Troy, I say, Reverend Washington, I'm so glad to see you. God will put a twist to that thing. God will put a twist to it and bless you like never before. I don't know how God do it, but I thank him.
Thank you, Lord.
Sometimes folks get upset with me how I help people, but I ain't gonna stop.
Come on.
They help me every time I do it. I can't help nobody.
Come on.
That don't mean every time I see you now. Somebody say glory. Sometimes I just want to see you to hug you. Amen, baby darling. But God is so good. I'm telling you tonight, you got to proclaim this thing. And the joy of the Lord. See, the question is, and there's a question mark on each one of us. Can God trust you with your deliverance?
Yes.
Can God trust you when he deliver you out of?
Yes, sir.
Wow. Yeah. Glory to God.
Tight, but it's right.
Come on, Bishop.
Hey, no, you say, well, Lord, I'm not next in line. I'm right now. Well, you better line up.
Yes, sir. Yes, Lord.
Before you can be right now.
Come on, Bishop.
You got to line up. So God can use you. You got to line up and be in his presence. What happened to loving your brothers and your sisters?
Amen.
What happened to loving one another. Don't just love the bishop.
Amen.
Come on now.
Love the bishop.
Yes.
Good word.
Amen.
Love everybody.
Amen.
Don't fix me no turkey and get up no chicken wings.
Tell them now.
Give everybody turkey. Lord, God can give you the spirit to get enough for the bishop. He can give you the spirit to get enough for everybody. You just got to want to do it.
Yes, yes.
That's right. I can't hear nobody.
Yes.
Yes, God.
Feed everybody.
Everybody.
Hallelujah.
Not just your two or three friends.
Come on now.
You don't feed them.
Yeah.
We come to church Sunday morning with a basket. We love for everybody.
Amen.
Don't wait till your enemies leave. Y'all come to dinner.
Come on now.
They gone. Y'all come on. Hey. Sit up. Somebody say glory in here.
Glory.
You ought to get excited about how God is using you. You ought to get excited because God chose to use you. You ought to get excited because God benefits you. You ought to get excited because God directed you to do it. You ought to get excited about working for the Lord. Stop singing, Lord, fix me until you want to be fixed. If you don't want to be fixed, we'll pick and choose us.
Right.
Somebody say glory to him.
Glory.
Oh, I wish everybody was here tonight.
Yes. You got a word.
Thank you. Man, singing for we got. I don't know. Well, folks be Valentine tonight. Something going on wrong. Valentine for couples, eh?
Maybe they got somebody.
They know something she don't know. Glory to God. God is a good God. An awesome God.
I'm where I'm supposed to be.
Well, next Valentine, you know what they know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Finally tonight, and we're going to get out of here. We got to learn how to not demonstrate selfishness. Can I say it again?
Say it again, Bishop.
We got to learn how not.
Amen.
Proclaim selfishness.
Amen.
I should be able to give you the same smile.
Amen.
The same love. Not no bad green, crazy eyes.
Oh, no. Come on, Bishop.
No. Like the smile on my face and my teeth. How do you smile and not show some teeth? Or gums?
I can smile.
In other words, pray to God to help you get delivered of that fakeness.
Yeah. Come on, Bishop.
Yes, Lord.
Because a real smile brings power. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
Everybody ain't crazy. Everybody here tonight?
Come on, Bishop.
Lord, I'm not next in line. I'm right now.
Right now.
Yeah.
Right now, Brother Taz. I'm right now, son. I'm right now. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. See, until you accept what you're sick and tired of, that you're going to work on it, you're going to get rid of it.
Yeah.
It's going to go home with you. It's going to follow you in the streets. It's going to follow you to the store. It's going to follow you to bed. You're going to sleep in it. You're going to dream in it. You're going to dream about it. You're going to do everything the devil wants you to do with it until you get sick and tired of being sick and tired. Do I have anybody that's sick and tired? You want to live free in God. You want to live in the image of Christ. You want to live Christ-like. You want to be Christ-like. You want to perform the duties of Christ. You want to be used by Christ, for Christ, with Christ, through Christ. Do I have anybody here tonight? Power on the inside that's trying to get out, that wants to get out.
Yes.
Everywhere you go, you're dragging its summit. But it wants to get out and perform for you. It wants to get out and make everything all right for you. It wants to get out and set you free. It wants to get out and get that stony heart out of you. It wants to get out and get that crazy mind out of you.
Yes.
It wants to participate. Lord. Only way you can move to your next level is to get caught up in the glory of God. In other words, you got to be ready to have a party with his glory. You got to let your temple be filled with the glory of God. And when you let the glory of God in, and the devil in hell can change it. He may come, she may come. It may come, but it can't stay. Oh, Lord. Do I have anybody tonight that's ready for a word like this tonight? On this Valentine night, do I have anybody that's ready to speak the truth and tell the devil I remember dismissing you on Valentine night? I remember set free. I remember kicking an enemy to the curb on Valentine night. I remember getting the dance on. I remember getting the groove on. I remember speaking in tongues on Valentine night. Told the devil to go to hell. Take a seat somewhere else. No more vacancies. No more pleasure. All I got is deliverance from the Lord. All I got is deliverance from the Lord. Because he lifted me on Valentine night. Somebody say 2018. It's when I really got it right. 2018 is when I really got the real deliverance and forgiveness and totally set free. Because I want what the Lord has for me.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I want it. What God has for me, I want it. Lord knows I can go further. But I'm going to stop right here and tell the Lord thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
All I know is I'm not next in line. But I'm right now.
Yes, right now.
For God's miracle.
Yes.
I'm right now.
Right now.
I said I'm right now.
Right now.
To get what God has for me. Oh, Lord. Right now, blessings.
Yes.
From the Lord.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
I don't know who you are tonight. It don't have to get tight anymore. Stop blaming yourself for failures. Tell God, thank you for living me.
Yes.
From that situation. Thank God for taking it out of my heart and set me free from being a servant of the devil. Lord, I thank you for delivering me and taking that sword from my heart. See, the devil don't get in your heart, Brother Bowtie. He can't bother you. He only bothers you when he gets in your heart. He can even be in your mind and not bother you. But when he gets in your heart, you can't shake him because your heart is a box. And you got it boxed in. I can't hear nobody. But if you want him to jump out, get out, come out, go away, you ought to just touch that heart and say, no more pain.
No more pain.
And no more gain.
And no more gain.
I'm done.
I'm done.
With all of that.
With all of that.
And God will.
And God will.
I say God will.
God will.
See you through.
See you through.
And make everything.
And make everything.
All right.
All right.
Come on and clap those hands. What God has for me, it is for me. What God has for me, it is for me. I know without a doubt that he will bring. What God has for me, it is for me. It is for me. What God has for me, it is for me. I know without that he will bring me out. What God has for me, he is for me. It is for me. It is for me. It is for me. I know without a doubt that he will bring me out. What God has for me, it is for me. It is for me. It is for me. It is for me. What God has me, it is for me. It is for me. Father God, we bless your name, and we thank you tonight, God, for the deliverance of this word. We thank you how you've consecrated our hearts and our minds, God, for this delivered word, God. We praise your name, God. We bless your name, God. Oh, God, we thank you for how you've operated, God, and how you've given us strength and power to be all right. God bless every heart here tonight, every person, every mind. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. Come on and clap those hands again. And tell the Lord thank you. It's offering time.